Let me also show you a true geek. I have every season of Highlander, the TV show. What if I happened? How would it gather? All of my favorite MCs haven't seen any of these comic book characters, and they became our season conceivable, unbelievable, and wild as it seems. The Emperor War and Stan Lee were coasting to a post. 9 to 10 discs. And for people who don't know, this is about an immortal who's just pretty much trying to get through life without losing his head. That might stretch from West Philadelphia to East Medina. If I'm able, I'd put it on pay-per-view through my label and give free tickets to my neighborhood bums with no cable. Yeah, that sounds bad. Now that we've squared away the
I'm such a geek that I even follow the spin-off. Set it off, it's the Raven. There was only one each other mentally with rhymes. These two team captains waste no time. Charles Xavier season of this. What was it? Two. Shot a cerebral probe, but it's all contained in this. Professor X taken out by the last this CD, the whole thing. And a spoiler alert, I mean it's old anyway, but this detective ends up being in the war also. I mean, it was obvious. Okay, who doesn't have 2600 magazines? That's not. Let me show you what truly is something. You want to talk about your collection of magic cards? Well, I actually never played magic. I actually played a newer game, you know, the Yu-Gi-Oh thing. I'll actually show you those, but if you want to talk about rare cards, I have here a birthday Pikachu, a White Star birthday Pikachu. This single card was once valued at $1,200 just for this, because it's so rare that I think, I might be wrong about this, but I think there's only 500 of these made in or shipped to the US, or 500 made all together. That's how rare this is. And still on the Pokemon thing, this is the Mew card. I have the fix for this, but this is the original printing of the Mew card. And what makes this so rare and so unique is it was printed by the company Nintendo, and it's on the, well, you won't be able to see it, but the Nintendo is spelled wrong. This is that card, that rare, misspelled Nintendo card before they fix it. This is the actual three-dimensional Wolverine Skybox black card. It's supposed to be so rare that there's like one of these cards in every 200 actual full cases, not packs, but full cases. And it's supposed to be rare to even get one. I got two of them. Can't really talk to you much about hacking because things I've done are illegal, but let me show you that I've gone to every one of the 2600, well, save one, conventions, hacking conventions, where the FBI sit around and watch us. I'm not sure if that's upside down or upside down. This clever card, they handed this to anybody who was in the convention. And with all the conventions, we're supposed to figure this stuff like out. And this ended up being not a satellite card like everybody thought, but this barcode allowed free access into the hotel, into all the hotel rooms for that convention. This this was, they hacked the hotel's door system. This was cute. Of course, this is the latest one I was at. That's my number. And before that, I was at the Hope number 5. It's, if you don't know what HOPE stands for, it's, well, you should know if you're a true geek. So I'm a web developer, but unlike you two, I've actually been programming a lot longer. And as far as the languages, I kind of lost count. I think I'm up to 20 something languages that I actually know and remember. And well, I'll list a few. There's C, C++, Pro-C, there's ASP, I know JSP, COBOL, I know SQL, Quick Basic, Visual Basic, DBase scripts, I don't know if you remember that, Pascal, Turbo Pascal, I guess you could say they're the same, RPG 2 and RPG 3, HTML, XHTML, CSS, I already mentioned JSP and ASP, JavaScript, C#, Java, I'm not sure what that was, if that was 20, how many that was, I even delved into assembly. That's one language I'm not familiar with. I use it, but I don't know it. If you really want to talk about programming, if you really want to, then you haven't programmed until you've actually made one that was self-aware. I'm not sure if you can read this. But after this, well, after being actually physically escorted out of the computer, the engineering computer room or lab, I cannot actually go back in without being arrested. I'm not a fan of Windows or Microsoft, as you can see, for anybody who knows what DOS is. Now I'll go into what else makes me a true geek. Reading my own encryption. I've actually made a files encryption. So if you, I guess it's for individuals, but if you actually encrypt something using my program on one computer and take that encryption, encrypted text, and if you know the key, and bring it to any other computer in the world, you can't decrypt it. It has to be decrypted on the very computer that it was encrypted on. That's how much of a geek I am. I'm not sure what my score is now, but I believe I passed both of you and Web Slime. Let's see.